Can I hear a big round of applause, everyone? We're about to get the Craftys started. Keep it going, keep it going. Get that energy up.
Woo! Neil Harris, everyone.
All right. You guys ready? Are we close? Yeah?
At a time when technology has oppressed the masses, we must celebrate things made with human hands. Welcome to the Craftys Awards, celebrating the best in craft and DIY, including knitting and crochet, edible craft, visual art, and much more. Judged by singer-songwriter Lisa Loeb, Amy Anderson, DIY Candy, U.S. Olympian, Thai Babylonia, Marley Burr, Yarn Thing Podcast, Marissa Pawelko, Modern Surrealist, Tamara Kelly, Moogly, and your host, Mark Montano. Welcome to the Craftys Awards for 2016.
Welcome to the Craftys Awards, the awards that celebrate the best in crafts. I'm Mark Montano, your glue and glitter for the proceedings. Sorry about all the security at the entrance. This is New York, and they really do need to check all of your purses and man purses for your glue guns and crimpers. It's like the TSA here. Because every New York moment comes with live music, I'm thrilled to be joined by Camille Harris playing 88 keys of sustainably harvested American hardwood trees. And joining us is the lovely Shannon, who is keeping us in line and keeping the eye on the trophies, and also helping me with the teleprompter. So if I mess up, it's her fault. Okay, it's not her fault. It's my fault. And hello to everyone watching at home. I assume you're all naked, and if you're not, get that way. Get comfortable. Just be careful with the kneading needles. Right about now, you're probably all wondering, an award show for crafters, really? Consider the numbers. About 700 movies are released each year, and they all get an award show. Now check the time on your watch. More than 700 Frida Kahlo coasters have been shellacked since I started talking, and twice as many booties have been crocheted. This is where the Craftys come in. There are award shows for video games, websites. There's even an award for worst acting. Yeah, I might get that. Okay, yeah. It's called the Razzies, right?
I think it's called the Razzies. You guys ever watch that?
Yeah.
I don't know.
In fact, some of the best crafts I've ever made have been in bed in my boxers while watching Madonna try to act. All right. Thank you. Now, before we get into the big awards for knitting, quilting, jewelry, and more, we just want to give an honorable mention to our favorite craft book of the year. And this is a real craft book, by the way. It is called Homemade for Hamsters, or as it's known in German, and I'm really going to mess this up, Selbstbegestelz for Hamster, which means Selbstbegestelz for Hamster. It is everything that you need to train your hamster to buy, gut, flip, and sell a cardboard condominium. It is a real book, and just FYI, Valentine's Day is right around the corner, so if you can't think of a gift for a loved one, we'll be taking orders in the lobby. All right. Are there any finalists in the audience? Yay! You're shy. I hope you win. Congratulations, and thanks for entering. If you win, just be careful not to trip down the stairs, because we can't afford, you know, to have people trip. Did everyone sign the waiver, by the way? These are very steep stairs. If you haven't signed the waiver, sign it, pass it forward, so we're covered. And now, Camille, how about a little rumble, because we're ready for our first award.
All right.
Really? That's all you got? I think you can do better than that. This is our first award.
You're right. How about...
Oh, Camille, come on. Everyone knows what you can do.
I know what to do.
Give us something here. talking about. That was amazing, right? Our first award for this evening is Best Decorative Painting and Mixed Media. How many times have we said, I'd love an embroidered picture of Guy Fieri, but I just don't know where to get one? Well, your prayers and to-go orders have been answered with the nominees from the Decorative Painting and Mixed Media category. Camille, take us away.
There's music to my eyes and Meeting Street House. There's Enchanted Fish by Susie Myers. I think that looks cool. Handmade Guest Wedding Book. These are all pretty awesome. Friends on Freeways. And Canvas Toes. Guy Fieri, welcome to Flavor Town.
Incredible.
I'm going to sing all of them.
We're going to be releasing tonight's music on iTunes later, so look for it.
I pre-wrote all of them.
Okay. This year, we'll be revealing the winners in the Craftys patented golden folder of truth. And the winner is... Brenda D. Cook for her hand-painted Christmas ornaments. Yay! Said one of our judges, I imagine seeing these on a tree and staring at them for hours. And so do I. Congratulations, Brenda. Woo! Guy Fieri isn't the only star appearing in tonight's cavalcade of crafts. The thin white Duke makes an appearance in our quilt circle. Plus, there are butterflies, toads, and pizza. Camille, what is the sound of quilts on Mars? And the winner of the quilting category is Sunlight and Shadows at Santee Coastal Reserve by Judy Lilly. As one of our judges said, the thread painting gives each tree exquisite detail and makes each stand out on its own. Congratulations, Judy. Now, before we announce the winner of this year's jewelry category, we wanted to check in with one of the nominees who used 100,000 jump rings to make a chainmail wedding dress. And part of us wants to know how she cleans it. I mean, does she sit in the dishwasher? Thank you. Here's a little more about Vanessa Valenko's amazing creation.
Since I was a kid, an only child, and thankfully a very indulgent mother who just bought me pipe cleaners and little pom-poms and then little seed beads from the time I was a kid. So I've been making jewelry since I was 8. So I got started with chainmail taking a class at a local art center, and I completely fell in love with the process. It hit every OCD bone in my body. So the inspiration for the chainmail dress was to create something that no one had ever seen before. Yeah. The project itself took a really long time. The construction alone was probably 300 to 400 hours, and that was over the course course of a couple of years. Because the dress is 100,000 rings, and the veil is another 12,000 rings. But the thing I'm probably most proud of are the anodized aluminum roses on the front of the dress. I wanted to create something like embroidery in the way that I could. And I wanted everything to be metal because it's a chainmail dress. So I found these beautiful pink roses and I pierced the petals so that I could take these even smaller anodized aluminum rings and connect the roses to the dress. Yeah, the first time I put on the finished dress was absolutely amazing because I had poured so much time and so much energy into this piece and all this brain power of just trying to logistically make it work. And then I just put it on and walked around my apartment for a while, just feeling very proud of myself. It's funny, I hadn't done any formal wear in fabric before tackling the chainmail wedding dress. So, I mean, now I sew and I do more elaborate pieces and I'm totally fine with it, and it's probably why, because I tested myself with metal first.
As you watch this year's jewelry category, try to guess which one was inspired by the sea, the Caribbean, and a newly planted seed. Jill McKay for her blossom necklace. As one of our judges said, the mixture in textures is really appealing. I like how she incorporated tools and techniques not traditionally associated with jewelry. Congratulations, Jill. This year, the Craftys introduced an award for woodworking, and the response was tremendous. We got a vase shaped like a pineapple, a coffee table that looks like a beetle, and an octopus made out of old skateboards. And then there's the piece that you're going to say, wait, who makes that out of wood? And the winner is Paul S. Church for the maple gown. Fantastic. Said one of our judges, the effort required to make this impressive gown, it utilizes not only woodworking skills, but also sewing skills and an eye for fashion. Congratulations, Paul. Wow. It's time for knitting. Do we have any knitters in the house? Come on, knitters, raise your hand.
Woo!
Oh, good. Have you explained to the little ones where pink pussy hats come from? Welcome to the 21st century interactive portion of the evening. How about this for some virtual reality? You ready? Can you catch yarn? More importantly, can I even throw yarn? I'm not very good at throwing. This is lovely yarn from our sponsor, Red Heart Yarns. Red Heart Yarns, thank you so much. By the way, if I rip this tuxedo, I hope one of you out there can sew it up for me. If not, I'm gonna get a few of you drunk and you can yarn bomb me. How about that?
Yeah.
And the stars are continuing to shine in the knitting category. After the purple one, Prince, just in case you didn't know that, left this mortal coil, Jill Vogan comforted her sister-in-law with a Prince scarf. And against the neck, Jill stitched a quote, "How could you leave me standing?
Alone in a world that's so cold. Maybe I'm just too demanding. Maybe I'm just like my father, too bold. Maybe I'm just like my mother. She's never satisfied.
Okay.
She's never satisfied." Okay.
Camille, she only stitched two lines. That would have really been the whole scarf. Yeah. But that was great.
Thank you. Anyone wants to go to karaoke, I will go with you.
All right, can anyone here make a starfish and a coffee cozy? Well, you've got the yarn for it, thanks to Red Heart. Now, here are the nominees.
There's Gone Too Soon, that scarf about Prince, and White Noise. Check out his awesome shine, a giant armpit bunny.
Yes, of course.
I still have one that my grandma made.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I love it.
You guys ever made a granny square blanket? Yeah, they're beautiful.
And the Craftys trophy goes to Ann Weil for Giant Arm Knit Bunny. Congratulations, Ann. An unusual idea, said one of our judges, and a fun way to combine two trends, floor pillows and arm knitting. Great stuff. Now for the best craft store category. There were many great craft store entries. Deco Coast makes beautiful mid-century modern coasters. Equa Ribbon is all projects made from horse show ribbons. Thomas Elk Fountain does Portlandia proud, printing retro maps on paper from America's oldest mill. Wow, that was a tongue twister. Instead of showing everyone's webpage, we decided to mix things up for this category and show you a profile about the winner, Loom Chicago, which creates a place for refugees to sell their wares.
احنا باللوم يعني من عدة دول.
إيراك بطا أنا أفريقيا بطا. عن النيبال
كل يعني دولة أو كل بلد له مثلا آثار قديمة هاي حتى واحد يأخذ من الله واحد يتعلم من الله
صافا أنا ساعتي ساعتي أمي لساني دي هي بني أبامي رديانة تيتا أنا بني تيرة غواي غاتين تيتا يبتدي ما تديانة أنت ميرو لوم تيرة ما تديانة
وين تيا غارا ما قتي جانا نيبال نب إنجليز نبون دشان تيزر لايك بوزا ونا كويسز غارسو تيا غارا ما أجا شكنا سانسو بني تيو دارا ناوسن
طبعا أنا بالعراق يعني كنت خياطة مدة 25 سنة 30 سنة أخيط، همين أعرف أنسج وأسوي كوشيه. اسمي ليزا، أنا من العراق وأشتغل كوشيه.
अरूले देख्दाखेरि हो अब आफ्नै सिप आफ्नै हातले बनाएको भनेर अब अरूले किनेर लान्छ होइन त्यही भएपछि अब खोइ त्यो कुन कुन संस्थाबाट सहयोग आउँछ होला थाहा छैन मलाई. माइ नेम इज गङ्गा तामाङ, आई एम फ्रम भुटान, आई एम अ लुम आर्टिसन, आई लाइक निटिङ.
पढ्दा लाँदा त धेरै नै सिकिन्छ पनि सिके पनि राखेको छ. अब कुन सामानलाई कति लाउनु लाग्छ किन्दा र कतिमा बेच्नु पर्ने त्यो धेर थोर मात्रामा अलिअलि सिकिन्छ सिक्यो. मेरो नाम यशोदा हो, म भुटानबाट आएकी हुँ र म यो लुङको एउटा सदस्य हुँ.
लुङ तबान बिनिस्बा इली मकान लरजक,
आफूलाई एकदमै भाग्यमानी ठान्छु, खुसी छु.
Congratulations to Loom Chicago, winner of our Best Craft Store Award.
Congratulations, Loom Chicago.
At this point, you're probably wondering, how many categories do these guys have? Remember, it's well within your rights to come up with your own drinking games for tonight. For example, every time I say the word bedazzled, bedazzled. You might want to just take a sip, you know, of some beer, for example. Oh, that's good, that's good. And while you're coming up with that drinking game, a big shout out to Brooklyn's Six Point Brewery for providing today's artisanal suds. Did somebody
bedazzled.
Say bedazzled? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now it's gonna get fun. Okay. This may be hard to believe, but we don't have best glass, best metalwork, or even best toilet paper roll crafts categories. And we definitely could.
Yeah.
Which is why we have the general crafts category, because we get so many astounding pieces submitted. We received a succulent head planter, an airplane for a cat, which was meowvelous, by the way. And finally, and recycled angel wings made out of plastic forks, knives, and spoons. And those are very hard to categorize. Still, very cool, though. Listen, who needs a romantic picnic in the park when you can sit at home and do that with your plastic forks, huh? There was also Christy Troxel's bohemian headdress, which I hear is here being modeled by one of her friends in the audience tonight. Is it? Is it here? Somebody's reaching somewhere for it, and she doesn't have it on yet.
I guess not.
Well, I don't know how you could categorize a beaded headdress like that, and that's just one of tonight's nominees. Camille, bedazzle us.
Oh, hey, bedazzle.
And the winner is The Bronx's own Paula Nadelstern.
Woo, Bronx.
For her beaded radiation mask. Pretty cool.
Come on up.
Said one of our judges, hey Paula, come on up.
Come get your award.
This was my first venture outside. I consider that actually a quilt, that radiation mask. It's if you have to have head or neck radiation, which I did, it actually is a plastic that is made for your head specifically, and it basically bolts you to the table for a number of minutes. It's very claustrophobic and unpleasant, so what does somebody who loves to bedazzle do? But you take it home, you throw it in a closet, and 5 years later when you can look at it again and you're very happy that it's 5 years ago, you make little kaleidoscopic beads, emblems, and put them all together, and that was the mask, the radiation mask. Thank you.
Beautiful.
That's fantastic. Said one of our judges, by transforming the radiation mask into a beaded crown, the patient can reflect the experience of the transformation in themselves. For anyone who thought the Craftys Baby Crafts category was for crafting with babies or for crafts made by babies,
You
were wrong.
Oh.
It is crafts for babies.
Oh.
Yeah, it's crafts for babies.
I did think mm-hmm. The other way.
The finalists include a mobile, a knitted sweater, burp rags, and a kolovory, which is Ukrainian. Does anyone speak Ukrainian? Topobachenya, is that Ukrainian or Polish? I don't know. Well, enough with the audience participation. Let's play the nominees. As can happen on a live show when there's technology involved. Buttons get pushed, wrong videos get played.
We've got a bedazzle.
People get bedazzled in ways we can't really talk about. Is going to be number one on iTunes, I guarantee.
It is already,
that was
actually
good.
It's actually already number one. So.
And the Crafty Award for Baby Crafts goes to Memory Quilt by Lauren Martin. Which one of our judges described as a priceless heirloom that's custom for the whole family. Congratulations, Lauren. Given that we may be facing the apocalypse at any moment, sewing is a craft you want to learn, and learn now. I mean, you're going to need to patch your jeans after the wolves attack you, and you're going to need to know how to stitch on your own arm after the zombies swarm. So learn. The nominees for this year's sewing category have already mastered the craft and include South Asian style bath towels, a beaded sea serpent, and a ginger fire Mustang stick horse. Camille? Announces the word of truth. The winner of the Craftys Award is Linda Johnson's horse show jacket. The judges said this combines a rock and roll attitude and meticulous sewing techniques. Congratulations, Linda, who was also a finalist last year. So, if at first you don't succeed, right? Another new category this year is duct tape crafts. Yeah, Don't worry, I'm not gonna toss these at you. I did ask though, and they said we weren't covered. But act up, I may reconsider. However, we do have Packy, the scrappy duct tape vendor, offering up tape. Anyone who wants a roll, just raise your hand. What's moving today, Packy?
Well, you know, Buffalo loves quite a whip. Loves the bacon. Yeah. Packy loves the bacon.
If you thought duct tape crafts were just wallets, we have something to show you. In fact, we have 10 things to show you. Let's roll the video. And the winner is Carrie Mott for Windy City.
That's made with duct tape.
Her duct tape paintings hang in Ripley's Believe It or Not museums. And after you watch this profile, you'll understand why. Or why not.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Carrie Mott. I'm 29. I live in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, and I am a duct tape artist. So basically, I create 2D images with thousands of little pieces of tape. I would say my duct tape venture started in high school. I would make duct tape bags for fun, and I would put designs on the front of the bags, and my designs became more and more elaborate and intricate. I am a person who loves very tactile things and very textured things. And I also like the idea of using regular household item in a very non-traditional way. I would say I essentially have no formal training in art. I went to college and got my bachelor's degree in neuroscience. And after I graduated, I thought I could be a doctor or a duct tape artist. So I picked duct tape artist. My parents are proud. And once I pick my subject, then I usually make a general sketch of my image and plan out what colors I want to use. And that's actually the hardest part, because every color of duct tape usually only has about 2 shades. So to create dimension and shading in my pieces, I have to get very creative. I would hope that my art could show kids and other people that you can think a different way, you don't have to do things traditionally, you can make up your own way of doing things. Yeah.
Paper cuts, permanent marker stains, and third-degree hot glue gun burns, these are just a few of the occupational hazards of paper crafters. We face them every day, all year long. This year's entries included little wrappers, a series of stickers designed to look like Biggie Smalls and Gucci Mane as children, and a diorama of New York City designed to fit on a New York cheesecake, which sounds really good right now,
yeah.
Right? Yeah. Neither of these made the finalist round, but you can bet the judges went through some serious screaming and mic dropping before that decision was made. Here are the nominees for the paper crafts and scrapbooking category. Christy Troxell, The Story of Sleeping Beauty. As one judge said, I love that it tells a story and sets a scene. Congratulations, Christy. One category that gets more entries than any other is crochet. Many of the nominees have amazing stories. And as this special finalist explains, crochet can even save your life.
Several years ago, I was diagnosed with severe Crohn's disease, and because of it, I've had to have numerous hospitalizations and many surgeries to try to get it under control. And my hospital stays weren't, you know, just an overnight kind of thing. They were 2 or 3 weeks at a time. One day, my mom ended up coming in my hospital room with a ball of yarn and a crochet hook, and she said, you know, you're not going to let this illness take over your life. she told me to, you know, teach yourself how to crochet. So I looked online on how to do basic stitches, and I learned how to crochet, and I ended up making a project, and I ended up feeling really accomplished. One day I saw a photo of the models, Gigi Hadid, online, and she was wearing a granny square cardigan, similar to this one, that was actually designed by Rosetta Getty, and I just wanted to make something like that on a budget, and so I was able to create this, and it soon became my favorite crochet piece that I've ever made in my whole life. This piece actually ended up taking me about a month to create. I ended up making each granny square separate, and then I sewed them all together. Something I really like is that I can create crochet pieces that are higher fashion pieces. I can also create things that are for different events, different holidays or highlights throughout the year, and crochet has helped me in such a horrible situation, and I was able to turn something so negative into something positive.
In the crochet category this year, we learned the things that you can crochet include peeping penguin boot cuffs, a sunshine lace tank, and a snuggly snail rug. Sounds very snuggly. Sing those sponsors. Hmm? It's really good.
Sponsored by Red Heart.
It's good. I love it.
Sponsored by Red Heart.
And the winner is Mandala Madness by Gul Amar. The color combinations are non-traditional but work well in this piece. If you're wondering exactly what constitutes an edible craft, just ask all of those people who take photos of their food before eating them, like me and...
I do.
Yeah,
I love it. Do you guys? I don't even post them. I just want to look at it later, you know?
Everyone thinks their next meal deserves a trophy, so I think next year we should have Best Instagram Food Photographer. What do you think?
Yeah, I think. What do you think?
Yeah? All right. In the meantime, here are the nominees for the Edible Crafts category. Yum.
Everything.
Those galaxy cupcakes were out of this world.
Whoa.
Huh? Are you hungry now?
Yes.
Well, in case you're hungry, we're going to hand out Craftys chocolates. Just a little amuse-bouche. And also, later on, we have desserts from Once Upon a Tart waiting for everyone.
Woo!
Yep.
Get your chocolates.
Get your chocolates. Packy's handing them out. Should we announce the winner of the edible crafts category? And the winner of edible crafts is the Paramount Theater by Blue Note Bakery. Which rebuilt Austin's 1950 movie palace in gingerbread. Pretty awesome.
Wow. I bet it tastes delicious.
Things are getting very exciting. We are in the home decor stretch when we traditionally sing God Bless Appliqué.
Ready, guys? God bless appliqué.
Our finalists in the home decor DIY category for this year include mid-century modern furniture for cats, meowvelous, a coffee table made with wood flooring, and a wreath made entirely out of pistachio shells.
Whoa.
Yummy.
Delicious.
All right.
Bobble wreath.
Stradling for pistachio shell wreath. That's hundreds of pistachio shells glued together in one beautiful, glorious wreath.
That's awesome.
We all know that bloggers like to cut to the chase. They like to focus on the important headline, so we're not going to bury the lead for Best Craft Blogger Award. Let's just say it. The judges came out big for Creative Green Living by Carissa Bonham.
Congratulations!
Said one of our judges, Creative Green Living is clean, inviting, with a great theme and great projects. Congratulations, Carissa. Now, if you're a crafter of a certain age, you probably first fell in love with upcycling your thrift store pleather jacket to the sounds of a singer-songwriter by the name of Lisa Loeb. So we were thrilled when she agreed to be a judge for the Craftys. Now, many of you have your own young creators crafting right along with you. So here's Lisa Loeb to announce the winner of the Young Crafter Award.
Hi, I'm Lisa Loeb, and as a touring musician, you learn how to do very important things like sew two trash bags together to make a tent, or how to whittle driftwood into making little napkin rings. I've also learned how to judge the highly competitive world of student crafting, which is why I'm thrilled to introduce the winner of the Craftys Awards Young Crafter category. The finalists include Zoe Walter's felt minion pillows, Nora Daly's lampshade made out of an old pink prom dress, and Callie Johnson's boho crossbody bag sewn with lace, silver, and suede. All of the projects were really inspiring. There was Jay's jewelry and the turtle necklace, the Aztec sleeping bag and recyclable self-portrait, the lapel jumpsuit, and who could forget the felt rabbit case. And the winner is Angela Land's jumpsuit made of rayon with an oversized lapel. Congratulations, Angela. You made a beautiful jumpsuit made out of rayon with oversized lapel. Very well made. Congratulations.
Now only one award stands between this audience and a bunch of beer and desserts. It's Best in Show. But first, we have a little business to take care of. Earlier today, we announced the winner of the Geek Crafts category on the Craftys site. It was a beautiful ceremony for all who attended, so go to the site and see. We also have one more reason to go to the Craftys site for a shopping spree and a giveaway from Consumer Crafts. And to enter, tell us your favorite crafts from the Craftys. To all of you and to our sponsors, including Consumer Crafts, Red Heart Yarns, DeReese, Red Heart Yarns, Duct Tape, did we mention Red Heart Yarns? Plus a big special thanks to Fave Crafts, Babbel, and Foodstirs. And now, the nominees for Best in Show. And before I announce that, I want to thank Camille for really, you killed it tonight.
Oh, no.
Thank you so
much. Thank you, guys.
And awesome Shannon for making sure I didn't bite my own tongue off. All right. And the winner is, for $1,000, Maple Gown by Paul S. Church. Your Crafty Awards. Congratulations to all the nominees, to all the winners, and to everyone who submitted their amazing crafts. I'm Mark Montano. That's Camille Harris. You're all wonderful. Thanks for watching and keep crafting.
Godless applique. Sing along. Technique that I love. Stitch beside it.
Good night, everyone. Woo!